Hello and welcome back to another episode in A Year Gardening, following my exploits through the year of 2020 in my garden. Now, we're now mid-September and I've got an area here in the vegetable garden which I've been using just to pile stuff up, and it's a bit of a mess. So I'm going to be clearing this out, getting rid of all the weeds, and I'm going to be planting my Christmas potatoes here. So that's a good start for the day. Now, there are still a few more jobs that I'm doing up in the garden, and I'm going to be putting the pond liner into the pond. I've got the layout already and some lining underneath, and I've been using some old carpet and sheets and things to soften the inside, and I'm going to be laying that in there as well. So quite a few things that I've got planned for today, but the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to start digging this area and tidying it, ready to take these Christmas potatoes. Well, I've just cleared all of the debris from this area. I had some timber and bits laying around down here, and I've cleared all that out of the way. So now I've got to start a fairly deep dig. There's a lot of bindweed and things in here, and I'm going to dig all of that out now and tidy this up. And it's going to give me a 2 metre by 1.5 metre border, which I can then use to plant some more vegetables in. Obviously, I will be putting some compost and bits into the ground to make it nice and usable, but I think it's going to be a nice addition to the vegetable area of the garden. Well, that's a nice start. We'll leave this for a couple of days now. I'll get some organic matter dug into this soil, and then we can start using it to grow some crops. It's not a bad soil underneath here. It's quite nice, very, very loamy, and will be great for growing things in. I mean, if stinging nettles are growing in the ground, then it's a good soil, and we had stinging nettles in here. So they're all dug up now. I just want to make sure that I give it a nice dig with the organic matter to get that in there, and just to improve the soil a little bit more. And I'm gonna get those Christmas potatoes planted in here. I'm sure this is really lovely. This soil just breaks up, it's beautiful. So it's not very clayey at all. Whereas the majority of the garden is clay, this is just powdering up in my hands. It's absolutely beautiful soil. And once we've got this worked, it's going to be great for growing in. So looking forward to that. Well, over the last couple of days, I've dug some organic matter into the ground here just to help it out, but I'm loving this soil. It really is nice. And I've put a trench in here now to take the first of my summer planting potatoes. These are going to be ready for Christmas. And the variety that I'm going to be putting in are Pentland Javelin. I'm going to do 2 little rows here. I'll have 4 seed potatoes in one, 5 in the other, which will give us 9 lovely plants to be digging up late November. Well, these have been sitting in an egg box in the greenhouse, and they've got some really terrific shoots on them, and I'm just going to put them into the bottom of the trench here, around about 10 inches apart, and they're going to be bringing on some of the vegetables for my Christmas dinner. So all I need to do is just to give those a little bit of cover, and I'm going to take the soil from this side and just cover those in, because I'm going to be putting another trench here so I can do with having a head start on the dig here. And I'm only going to be covering them very, very lightly, a couple of inches at tops on these, just to get them all nicely started. And this is the stuff that I've been digging out of here. There is tons of that. Bindweed, that's going to go into the incinerator. There we are. So I'll just get this nicely covered over here. Obviously, I'll be then marking the rows, and these will be a nice, tasty addition to our Christmas dinner for once. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave this soil banked up over here. I use that for earthing these potatoes up as they grow. and this is going to be the start of the next trench for the next row of these Pentland javelins. Well, there we are, two trenches of potatoes, little ridges in between them, all ready for growing through the late season this year. And I've never grown summer planting potatoes before, and I'm really looking forward to seeing how this turns out. Now, one of the jobs that I've got to sort out now is to clear all of this pallet area away by the compost heaps here, because we're going to be putting a gate in next to this post here, with my next door neighbours very kindly offered the use of the bottom of his garden to extend our vegetable growing. And we're going to do some planting and some learning together. I'm going to be putting in four or five raised beds there for growing some more crops next year, because I'm basically running out of space here, and there's spare space in Stuart's garden, so we're going to work together and get some nice crops growing in there for next year. So this has got to come down. Well, it's a constant job, but taking off these dead heads from the roses is a very, very rewarding job, because I'm being rewarded with new flowers on a very, very regular basis. And they just keep coming back. They keep coming. And it's so beautiful to see this in the garden. Just clipping these off. And we've got to take this one out at the top here. And there. And we'll probably get more buds on there again this year. We've got a lot more buds coming through on these plants here, and some lovely quality roses. Absolutely beautiful. And the scent is just something to die for. And we'll just take this little bit out here. Beautiful flowers, amazing scent. And if I keep just deadheading all of these plants, what's going to happen now is we'll get more flowers coming through into very late summer and autumn. It's been such a joy, this piece of garden this year, and I wondered to myself why I didn't do it before. Now, if I just move the camera around, I want to show you on the Rudbeckias. You may well pick it up from here. If I just zoom in a little bit, kind of adjust that there, and then zoom in onto the Rudbeckias here. Now, on there, I don't think we can see it that well at the moment, but the petals are dying off, and they're leaving these lovely black heads. And they're a beautiful dome. The birds are loving it, the butterflies are loving it, and the architectural form of them is absolutely superb, and I'm really enjoying looking at it myself. It's also time for me to work on these here. This can be cut right down, but once there's a little bit of flower on there, I'm going to leave some of the flower to attract the moths and the bees and the butterflies and things. They're still loving this, but there's a lot of dead form on here which I need to remove and just smarten it up a little bit, and we can just come through here. And I mean, what I will probably do with this in a month or so's time is take it right down to a couple of inches, and it won't do the plant any harm at all. It's a very, very hardy plant. But we'll take a lot of this dead stuff off. I won't take all of it off, because I do like the seed heads and the shapes it gives us. But it's just nice to tidy it up with the garden. And I'll carry on working away around on this now. Well, very often we get a little bonus in the garden. Now, I've just been cutting down the lemon balm and clearing that ready for its new growth to come through. And I found all of these little baby nasturtium plants growing here. And this is where plants in the summer have self-seeded. And they're going to give us, hopefully, a nice autumn display with their lovely orange and yellow flowers. These are absolutely divine. It feels like velvet. Absolutely feels like velvet on these lovely heads. So, bonus time. Happy days. Well, last week I showed you my part-built fence up the side of the hedge. And I just wanted to show you I've now completed that. And the fence is built. And the whole thing has been built out of scraps. And you remember that I put this up at the end here, just over the dead bit of hedge. But the whole thing is built all the way down the garden there. And those pallets are going to be recycled and used for creating the gate through to the extension on the garden into Stuart's garden, which is quite handy. Well, here I am back at what will be the wildlife pond. This is Doug, and now I've got loads and loads of soft lining inside. This is all old sheets, carpets, pillowcases, all stuff that we were going to just destroy and turn into rags, but it's actually going to be very, very useful for the lining underneath the pond liner for the wildlife pond. Now, what I've got here, this end I'm sitting on, is going to be around about a 6-inch shelf. We're dropping down to just over a meter in the middle. Then we've got a shelf at this end, which is around about 450 mil, about just under half a meter. And then it's going to go to a beach effect around the top. So the water's going to be coming in at this level here. And as you can see, that's going to go to a beach there, and it's going to go to a beach at this end, so that animals and bits and pieces can come in and out as they please. And the shelves will allow us to plant some rather nice wild plants to help keep the water clean and fresh, and to encourage the wildlife as well. So the next job that I've got to do is I've got to go and unpack the actual black liner for the pond and pop that inside here, and then we'll pop some water inside that so that it can find its level. I won't be cutting the liner for a couple of days. I'm going to let the water just bring it down, and then we'll see how it goes from there. So no more digging here, please, because this was darn hard work. Okay, so what I've done now is overlaid out the polythene in the, or whatever the black stuff is that the pond is made of, and I've allowed a lot of spare on the left hand side and then a little bit less on the right. So that will allow me then to cut this through and join in with the stream. And so what we're doing now is we're just going to fill this with water and let it stretch through into place, and then we're going to let it settle, and then we'll see how it looks from there. So all moving on, all very, very happy. Well, I'm sure you can see as the water goes in, the shape for the bottom section is filling up. We've got the shelf just over this side here, and we've got another shelf up here. The water level is probably around about a quarter full at the moment, and already we've got a nice shape appearing in there. Now, water pressure is very, very low down here because we're around about 100 feet away from the garden tap, so it's not that brilliant. But as this continues to go in, I'll be able to just then bring the plastic around to fit onto the shelves and the sides, and I'm sure this is going to look absolutely splendid. Well, as you can see, the pond area is probably around about half full now. That's the main area at the bottom where the pump is going to sit, is fairly full, and it's now building up to the shelves, and this will then start to pull down the plastic from the edge, and I've already pulled that underneath at the side here to lead into the stream, and the feed looks like it's going to be nice. And then once the water has just settled the levels, and then we can cut this all into place, and we can start placing the stones around the edge. Very much looking forward to this. Okay, so what I've done now, I've basically 90% filled this with water, and we've got a lot of water in here now, and I'm just going to leave this to rest and settle for 24 to 48 hours to settle itself down, and then I'm going to tidy the edges, roll this underneath here, get the weed suppressing membrane underneath here, then I've got to cut this and trim it through to join in with the stream, link it in, put a waterproof seal on there, and then we can test run the stream through to the pond. Happy days. Well, that brings me to the end of episode number 24 in a year gardening. Now, I've been putting out some more seeds for next year to get the garden looking great for 2021. And that's going to be hopefully a different year to this one. Well, we've had quite an enjoyable day today putting all this together, and I hope you agree with me that now the pond's in place, we'll be able to get the stream running very, very soon. I've got the pipe work ordered and the pump ordered so that we can run all this through the garden and get the water filtering all the way through, which will be really, really great. So I'd like to thank you very much once again for joining me, and this has been such a great year. Now, in the next episode, episode number 25, I'm going to have a little review of some of the stages we've been through in this year and some of the changes that the garden has gone through. And it's incredible when I've been looking back at some of the videos to where we are now, where we were just 9 months ago. It's such a change. But I do appreciate you being on board with me through this journey, and we've still got a few months of this year left. But hey ho, I'm going to leave you today. I've got a little glass of something, which is rather unusual for me. So I've got this rather lovely claret, and again, only just a small glass. But stay well, stay safe, be kind to each other. Cheers.